obviously you've tried some rounds. And so give me a little bit about when it started, how it felt, how it feels now.
It started pretty suddenly, actually. I just started to get a pinging sort of, or, you know, stabbing in my head. And then eventually it went to electrical shocks up through my forehead and into my head. And was being treated for a sinusitis and an ear infection for 3 months on antibiotics and steroids, but the pain was still there and the pain did not go away.
Here you can see the second bone in your neck right there. See, there's a lot more of it to the left than there is to the right. See that? And we have a 4 millimeter shift. A half a millimeter can cause major problems. 4 millimeters is almost off the chart. Yeah, we want this yellow line straighter.
Well, how I got here was by accident, actually. My sister walks with an osteopath, and she was telling me that I had trigeminal neuralgia, and she said, you must get her to an upper cervical care person as soon as possible. Mm-hmm. Then I finally Googled upper cervical chiropractic, and I came up with you first. Mm-hmm. And otherwise, there was very little information, so I had to dig around a little bit even to find your book and find other information about upper cervical care.
Good.
It hit me that it made so much sense to me that that's what could be wrong, is that I had a pinched nerve as opposed to surgeries that drill a hole in your head and go in there with a crochet hook and start looking around for a nerve.
Right, exactly. And so you came, how far away? How long did it take you to get here?
Well, it took me 6.5 hours to get to my sister in West Virginia. Uh-huh. And then we spent another 6 hours to get from there to here.
Right. Now, there was somebody else with your sister, too, that had a different opinion, right?
Right. She also walks with a medical, an MD, who on other evenings, and she said, oh, that's probably not going to work. You know, we don't believe in that sort of thing.
Monday, we x-rayed you, checked you, you got your first upper cervical adjustment, and so how's it going for this
week? Well, I had a twinge the first day, and I thought, oh boy, you know, I had a twinge. Uh-huh. But it was really just a twinge, not the regular shock that I usually get. And I haven't had anything since then, so today's Thursday, so I haven't had a pain since Tuesday, I guess.
Right. And so, I mean, is that unusual for you?
That's very unusual. Usually there's something, either brushing my teeth or washing or trying to, I don't touch that side of my face, but even the wind or something. So I haven't had anything like that.
Awesome.
You're going to get a lot of help from me. Yeah. I already have a list of people who need upper cervical care.
Absolutely.